Thanks, Mr. Huerta-Sumido.
Now let's watch this feature on former Eisenhower social studies teacher, Mr. LaCitra.
Hi, we're here with Mr. LaCitra.
So, Mr. LaCitra, when did you start teaching?
When I was a young man, a long time ago. Right out of college, I was hired. I came here in 1972 in September. Spent the next 39 years growing older. My students remained the same age. I don't get it. And then I've retired and subbed here this is 4 years now.
How is Eisenhower different from when you were teaching?
School certainly changed. The physical plant, obviously. You know, when I got here, you had the, what is today maybe part of the sixth grade hall. There were the two main halls, and you had the courtyard and the calf. You had the gym, and behind the gym was outside, where we had a couple of portable classrooms that were being erected. And where the eighth grade wing is now, they had a couple of portable classrooms there as well. We just had seventh and eighth grade at the school. We had close to 700 or more students in just the two grade levels. We had so many students that not only were some of them in portables, but one of the teams of students, and that's when we first started teaming students together. Every student had the same language arts, math, science, and social studies teacher. And one whole team of students went up to Bethany Church, and they spent part of the day being taught up there, and then they came back down here for certain other classes. We just didn't have the room. And then over the years, the physical plant changed. I taught in the main hall for a couple of years, and then we went. Then I taught out in the portable classrooms behind the gym, which was great because we had a front and a rear entrance to the classroom, and there were many times when we were able to just go out and sit outside where it was nice and teach there. You had classrooms that were taught in the courtyard, the playground, which is where the new multi-purpose room is and the music rooms are today. That whole playground, you had three full court basketball courts there for the students to play at recess. You had a fenced in tennis area with two tennis courts, and there was a lot of room for everybody to do all kinds of sports.
Did you do anything besides teaching?
I did a lot of things besides teaching. I thought as a teacher it was best to be involved as much as possible. I started my first year here, I just went to a lot of the kids' ball games or watched them play after school. I used to go to gym class a lot and play with the students there. But by my second year, I was asked to coach the girls' basketball team. And now here's the difference. My first year teaching here, or maybe just before I was hired, girls' basketball used to be half court. And you had about six players. You had three on one side of the court and three on the other. It was totally different than boys' basketball. I think the coach at that time, when they changed it to be just like boys' basketball, was a little nervous about handling that and asked to be relieved of her duties and wanted to know if I wanted to take it. I did. I became the girls' basketball coach for the next about 19 years or so. I did that. I coached boys baseball for a couple of years and helped out with soccer. I officiated soccer. I umpired the baseball games. I officiated basketball games when I wasn't coaching. Intramurals. That was another whole thing that we did. When I started here, there was an intramural flag football for a short period of time, and then that faded away. Although Mr. Charlo, one of my former students, when he came back and others, they set up the turkey bowl, I believe it was, where they had turkey or the intramurals for a tournament for football. And let's see, there was flag football, and that was about it. There might have been a few other after-school activities in terms of basketball, but really not much intramurals until Mr. Jevick and I, who was a longtime teacher here since retired, Mr. Jevick and I, and later on Mr. DeBlock, took over for him. We set up what was called the intramural hockey. And back in the day, intramural hockey was the thing to play. There were far less things for students to be involved with after school. So we would have, 8, 10, 12 teams. Students would come to the games. They would wear all kinds of regalia for their teams. They would chant down the halls. It got quite crazy, and of course we created what was called the Eisenhower Cup. And the Eisenhower Cup has been signed over the years by the winners of our tournament. And so some of your older brothers or sisters or cousins or what have you, that was quite the thing to do.
I'm former Eisenhower student and Fox News reporter Kevin Berry.
So how did you become a news reporter?
Well, I guess kind of after I left Eisenhower, I went to Ramapo High School, and that's where I was in the Communications University program. After high school, I went to college, and I went to Syracuse University and majored in broadcast journalism. And then when I left Syracuse, I wanted to go into news, and so I just applied for jobs kind of across the country in all different markets. I think I applied to 80 different television stations, and finally I was able to interview with and ultimately got my job in Cedar Rapids, Iowa as a news reporter and a multimedia journalist, which means that some days I work with a photographer who shoots all the video for the story, and then some days I do everything myself. So I'm actually called a one-man band, where I shoot all the video and I do the reporting as well.
Why did you want to be a news reporter?
I really enjoy the storytelling aspect of it, in the sense that, I mean, if you were to walk down the street, no matter how many people you see, everybody has some kind of interesting story, even though it might not always seem like it. And so what I think is really fun is finding those people and finding those stories and then being able to tell them. And, I mean, what I really enjoy about being a news reporter is that there are two different stories. There's your informational stories, which kind of teach you something and make you more educated about the world around you. And then there's more emotional stories that make you feel something. And I think both of them play a really important role. And that's why, you know, I enjoy one day maybe doing a story about the Affordable Care Act, or here in Iowa, we do a lot of stories about the Farm Bill. And then, you know, you can turn around and do a story about a little girl who got a heart transplant to save her life.
How did your time at Eisenhower /ETV play a role in becoming a news reporter?
Well, obviously, like what I was talking about before, you're kind of elementary school and high school education, and obviously education in college plays a really big role, because I have to know a fair amount about a lot of different things over kind of a broad spectrum. As far as my time at ETV, though, that was really one of the first times that I was in front of a camera. When I was in elementary school, I went to Washington, and we had kind of a TV show in that sense. It was a little bit different. So that was, like, I think my first time in front of a camera doing the news or telling stories in that sense. But at ETV, I definitely had a lot more experience with going out and shooting video and putting packages together, even though they're a lot different than the stories I might do now. It was the first time where I got to see the whole process from start to finish, from going out, creating your own video, doing interviews, putting it all together, and then having your finished product. That laid a really good groundwork for me when I went to high school, and then high school laid a good groundwork for when I went to college. But I'd say probably ETV was one of the first times that I really got the whole package of what it means to put something visual, an audio-visual product together.
What's your favorite memory of being a student here at Eisenhower?
My favorite memory? It would honestly
besides my science class.
Oh, I'm sorry, say again?
Besides my science class.
Absolutely. I'm thinking it would probably be baseball. I really enjoyed playing baseball at Eisenhower. It was the first time I had played for my school. And I had played, like, traveling baseball, you know, all throughout, you know, from when I was in second grade. But playing baseball at the school is a little bit different, in the sense that, you know, it was kind of cool to have, you know, your classmates come to the game after school and watch you guys play and, you know, wear your jersey around mm-hmm. school and things like that. And then after I left Eisenhower, I went off to play baseball at Ramapo as well for 4 years. And that was really a blast. You know, it was a lot of the same kids. And, I mean, baseball was something I really enjoyed when I was a lot younger. I have snapshots of classes yeah. and things like that, but I'm not sure anyone would say, oh, like, I really enjoyed that test I took.
Right, you know? Exactly.
And so I think that's what I really enjoyed kind of taking away from it, was the camaraderie you feel being on a sports team and having people come out to see you.
Yeah. So. Well, listen, I remember you as a student. I do remember you distinctly as a student. You're an excellent student, a very hard worker, very engaged in class, so the other students here can learn from your success now, I think, is due to your hard work, probably, and your intelligence and your determination. So best of luck to you. I want to see you on TV here in New York before you know it, all right? And come back and visit us here at Eisenhower soon.
I hope so, too. It was great to talk to you as well, Mr. Lee. Thank you very much.
Take care.